how you will go about it so that you will not step your feet in it. Oh no. This is the time where you look at the lion eyeball to eyeball. You say, oh, it doesn't matter whether you stand out there or you don't stand out there. Whether it is a tiger that is out there or it is not out there. It doesn't matter. I don't care if it is a bear that is standing out there. I will put on my jacket and I will arm myself and I will face that bull by the horn. Amen. And you pick up your things. And in the snow, come on. You will be strolling in the snow as somebody will be strolling around the beach. It is all determined. It is all pre-programmed. It must come from the heart. You must decide on that. If you don't decide on that, I tell you that you will be knocked out. And we call it what? K.O. We call it K.O. Knock out, K.O. Like that. Not that you are weak. No. It's just your spirit. It's your spirit. You must prepare something in there. Now, for your information, anything that happens, it doesn't matter what you see out here. In the physical, it's just the manifestation. But it was done in the spiritual before it manifested. Heaven and earth, God planned it already. Before you were free, before you were delivered, before salvation came, before Jesus Christ rescued you, it was planned in heaven. You remember the day God was asking, who will go? The angel said, no, me, nine. Satan at that time was Lucifer. He said, me, nine. Jesus Christ. The Bible says that he was slain right from the beginning, right from the foundation of the earth. He said, yes, sir, I will go. And because he determined to come, he was not joking when he said that I will go. He was not playing. He was not eating pap. He was not drinking tea. He meant what he was saying. This is a man of integrity. When he spoke, when camp came out of his mouth, he backed it in action. It doesn't matter what he saw. If it was a human being, you came on earth here, you saw people begin to threaten you. They carry axes, they are hitting you. They spat on your face. They say, come, they were going to tie you on the cross. They went and did this cap in the form of thorns. They will put on your head and they will hit it. They put you on the cross, six inches here on your feet. And your hands stretch all over like that. You say, hey, no. Oh God, I made a mistake. Sorry, I made a mistake. Please let me come back. Because it was a risk. It was hard. But he did it anyway. He did it anyway because he has made promises. Because of the love that he has for you, and the love that he has for you, and the love that he has for me. Jesus Christ spoke and he did it. And now he's our master. The Bible says that he sits at the right hand side of God. He is interceding for you and for me because he's our advocate. Hallelujah. He is our master, the one that we follow, the footstep that we follow. Because there is no other footstep that we can follow than a flesh and blood who live a life of purity upon the face of the earth and yet committed no sin. Will you also engage in that? Will you also find yourself in that situation where when you give out your word, you back it out? It doesn't matter how expensive it will be. It doesn't matter how hard it will be. A man of integrity, when the words are released from your mouth, you don't call the word back anyhow. But you stand firm. You don't care how the cost is going to be. Because you know tomorrow, that word is going to multiply the benefits. It is going to yield fruits because you back it up. You know, when it comes to integrity, it's something that takes a long time to build. I like how God said here. But it takes a minute, tap, you have destroyed everything. So we must be careful in life. Whatever we do, people will meet. We should not take people for granted. Jesus Christ, God loves everybody. Let us love. Let love be a cord in our lives. Let it be a bond in our lives that ties us together and we can never be broken. That is the only time that we can survive in life. That is the only time that we can achieve. That is the only time that you can sharpen me and I sharpen you. But if we wave and we shake like a shaking shadow, it's not going to work in life. We're all going to fail. We will crumble. One will pull the other one down and the other one will hit the other one down and so on and so forth. You plant somebody down, not on solid foundation, or you grant somebody on scriptural foundation and you know that that person is going to fall. You make that hit the person at the back. Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come, and this is the time. The time has come, and it is now. But we have to begin to make decisions on how to handle life, on how to live on this planet Earth. We were not born to live alone. No, we were not. We were not born to live only in this number that we are here. No. Because all what we need in life, all of us here, we don't have. Each one of you here, we have our various gifts. We have our things that what we do. We are very, very blessed in it. We are intelligent in it, and we can do it so perfectly. God had a purpose for each and everyone's life before you were created. You were not formed by mistake. I don't care whether you were born out of wedlock. I don't care whether you were born in out of in-law or whatever. I don't care as you care. But the fact that you are a human being, it means that God planted and he had a purpose. Now God created something. He has some assignment that he has to give to somebody. And he said, I have to create somebody. It doesn't matter the situation. When he creates that person, so he hits the person with that thing, with that purpose. So we come up here with our own purpose. You have something that you have to deliver to the world. I have something that I have to deliver to the world. The question is, are we going to allow those things to come out so that the world may be different? Are we going to allow those things to come out so that the world will be different? What are we going to allow those things to come out so that some changes can happen? So that somebody's life will be lifted up. Somebody is waiting for that thing that is in you. That when it is manifested, that it is released, it's going to be the person's foundation. It's going to be the person's stepping stone. It is going to be the slate, a springboard on which when that person stands, it's going to lift that person up. Are you ready to release that thing? Are you ready to release it? Question to you. Answer this question in your heart. Amen. If we believe in God, we must do the things that God says we should do. We should be obedient to Him. Obedience to God, it is not because God is going to be more God. He is not going to increase. He is not going to change because of our obedience. Obedience to God is for our own advantage. It's for your benefit and it's for my benefit. So I will not afford not to obey God. Because I know if I do it, it's for me. It's for me. It's not for him. Whatever money is collected in the church, whatever service is granted to the church, whatever thing you think is a service unto him, yes, it is a service unto him, and he likes it that you do that. But for your information, whether you do it or you don't do it, he remains the same.